A very good morning to one and all present here. Let us begin this interdisciplinary workshop with the famous quote, "A good teacher inspires hope, ignites the imagination and instills a love of learning in young mind." Now I invite our HOD, Dr. A. Narmada ma'am, to deliver the welcome address and the introduction of our chief guest.
Thank you, ma'am. Very good morning, one and all present here. On behalf of Department of Management Studies, D.B. Jain College, Chennai, I extended a warm welcome to you all to the 7th day interdisciplinary workshop on the topic Teachers' Role in Boosting Mental Health of Young Mind. I feel extremely honorable to introduce our chief guest and my friend, Professor M. Bharathi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, D.B. Jain College, Chennai. She has completed her MCA in National Engineering College, Kovilpatti, and a M.Tech in SRM University. She also cleared NET exam in the year 2018. She has more than 11 years of teaching experience. She has published several research papers in referred journals. Moreover, she is a good teacher and motivational speaker for young and energetic students. We are really thankful to you, ma'am, for taking the time out of your busy schedule. Once again, I welcome you one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now, I would like to invite the most honorable personality of this morning, Professor M. Bharathi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Dhanraj Bain Jain College, Chennai, to take and hand the topic, Teacher's Role in Boosting Mental Health of Young Mind.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning, everyone. First, I would like to thank D.B. Jain College Management, Principal, Professor in Charge, Dr. M. Shaktivel Murugan sir, and Department of Management Studies, HOD, my friend Dr. A. Narmada, for having me today. Thank you, ma'am, for the very nice introduction. And I hope you're all staying safe and healthy through these unusual times. And we people live in a situation where mental health needs to be elevated positively. And as a mentor, we too have the responsibilities to guide our students to develop a healthy mindset. Yeah. And yes, this is the topic given to me today. And let me share my screen now first. I hope you can see my screen, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. And I would like to start my presentation with the phrase, "The key to a healthy life is having a healthy mind," of course. And a very simple example, I just want to start my presentation. Say, for example, at home, if the kids ask us something while watching comedy series, how we respond? And at the same time, while watching a thriller or some suspense movies, how we respond to them. Just compare both the responses we gave to our kids and also analyze how your mood was after watching the different genre. What I'm trying to say from this example is, to have a good mental health, we should need to think, listen, and watch some positive things so that we can create the positiveness. Healthy mind always plays a key role for our success. And yes, this is the topic, teacher's role in boosting mental health of young mind. And let me start with my presentation with the definition of mental health first. And according to the psychology, mental health includes our emotional, psychological, and social well-being. And mental health, it determines what we think, feel, how we handle success, failure, stress, and etc. And tips we can share with our students to boost mental health during this contagion period is, let them eat healthy food and get up plenty of sleep and be active, and always ask them to engage with the hobbies what they are interested in. And of course, we have to disconnect ourselves from negativity and volunteer whenever possible to the needy people. This is what we can share with our students to boost their mental health. And what is the current mindset of our students we can define as? And in this pandemic period, the student's life has completely changed, and our students' lives and mind has changed, disrupting their college and their daily routines and worrying about their safety and being unable to see their friends and family and fears about their futures. And it all have contributed to an increase in mental health problems. Goal setting is a powerful process for thinking about their ideal future and for motivating themselves to turn their vision of their future into reality. And they will definitely feel the confidence and positive when they have a goal and some planning to achieve the goal. This is what we can suggest our students. And this is what we can categorize our student mindset into. A famous psychology professor from Stanford University, Carol Dweck, who researches personality and development, popularized the philosophy through her book, Mindset. She explains students' mindsets as fixed mindset and growth mindset. And with the growth mindset, just a motivation and guidance is more than enough for the students who know they can develop their skills and talents through effort and persistence, as well as being receptive to lessons and feedback. They generally believe they can improve through hard work and trying learning new things. But with the fixed mindset students, they too have their own skills and talents and some intelligence, of course, which are in the fixed traits. They may resist learning new things and they are not having interest in trying any new things, typically feeling embarrassed when not understanding something. Help your students to feel comfortable in learning or accepting new challenges always. And from this, what we teachers can do is, the more concentration or more motivation we have to give is a fixed mindset of people who are also eligible to achieve the things, but they need much more motivation from the teachers or from the parents or from their friends. And this is what the mental health, which can be improved, of course, with the physical activity. How the mental health can be improved is, a very clear distinction is often made between mind and body. But when considering mental health and physical health, the two should not be thought as separate. Poor physical health can lead to an increased risk of developing mental health problems. Ask the students to do some regular exercises. It can have a profoundly positive impact on depression, anxiety, etc. And it also relieves their stress, improves memory, and helps them to sleep better and boost their overall mood. And let me share the factors which may affect students' mental health positively and negatively. And positively, in the sense, self-esteem, which comes first. Self-esteem and perceived competence are necessary for students to take risk in their learning and to bounce back after failure or adversity. What we teachers can do is give specific and genuine positive feedback on effort rather than the outcome. Say, for example, you made a lot of progress on that project in just an hour. Just a comment you can share with your students about their project work, some positive feedback they are expecting from you always. Or you can say, like, the topic sentence of that paragraph, what you made is really strong. Such a motivation or such an appreciation will help the students to make much more better next time. That is what. And another positive factor what we can share here is feeling loved. Students who feel loved, trusted, and accepted by their parents and others are far more likely to have good self-esteem. They are also more likely to feel comfortable, of course, safe and secure, and are better able to communicate and develop positive relationship with others. And of course, the confidence, it is what a major factor which can affect students' health positively. Youth should be encouraged to discover their own unique qualities. And have the confidence to face challenges and take risks. young people who are brought up to have confidence in themselves are more likely to have a positive attitude and to lead happy and productive lives. And if you go with the negative factor which may affect our students' mental health is what? The biggest thing is what, the family breakup or a loss of a parent, which may definitely affect the student's mental health. And of course, the poor physical health, which can affect self-esteem and people's ability to meet their goals, which leads to unhappiness or even depression. And financial crisis, of course, it definitely affects everyone, particularly the age of the students. And they are having much more troubles nowadays in paying their fees, etc. And they definitely need some proper guidance and support from the teachers and of course from the society. And abusement, it may be, this is what an another important negative factor, which may be a physical, sexual or psychological or verbal abusement. Say for example, we can prepare our students' mindset to react boldly while experiencing abusement that may be in any form. And what we teachers can do, main thing is our words, which have the power, we have to use them wisely. We have to guide them, or we can share the things with them, how they should react in some tough times, what they are facing in form, any form of abusement. And these are some positive and negative factors. And this is what we can share with our students and ask them if they are experiencing this kind of negative things, what they will do. We can give suggestions and guidelines to our students if they are having this kind of negative factors in their students to come out of it. That is what. And the benefits of mental health is what? Of course, a good mental health leads to increase in concentration, clears your confusion, and can feel the good sense of humor and improvements in relationships. Help the students to know the importance of mental health through physical fitness. Okay. And which may include sharper their memory, clarity in thinking, higher self-esteem, better sleeping time, and it of course increase the students' energy level in positive. And a very kind attention to the participant. This is what a very small mental assessment. And hope you can see some two set of list in the screen now. List A and list B. And two set of list are listed out here. There are some common words listed out in both the list. Some are not in common. Find those words which are not common. Kindly find those words which are not common in both the list. Kindly type it in the chat box, which is not common in both the list. It may take some 1 minute. Kindly involve yourself in finding out the odd element in both the list. And please type it in the chat box. What the two set of list. Hope the time is enough for you all now. Nandana ma'am, shall I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And through this assessment, what I would like to share here is some of us may finish it in less time with the correct answer. Some may not have interest to, may not have interest to work on it. But what we all expect at final is what a small appreciation from our friends or from our teacher. That is what the students nowadays expecting from us. We teachers have to appreciate our students' work always. It may be submitted, completed, completely or they may submit it partially, but we need to appreciate their effort, what they have made. Some people may not put any effort at all, but we have to appreciate about their past work so that they may finish it or they may complete it better in the next time. That is what. This is what I would like to share with you all. Appreciation is what an another key for getting a healthy mind. Always motivate your students by appreciating their work. This definitely makes their mental health to think positive and they will do their better in future, that work in future. Okay. And in short, the role of teachers in boosting mental health of young mind. And the teachers who plays the most vital role and is as important as parents in molding the personality of the student. And what parents are at home, the teacher is at college. The teacher has a responsibility not only towards the child's education, but also towards the child's full-fledged mental and emotional growth. Ask your students to set a goal. Goal setting is a powerful process for thinking about their ideal future and for motivating themselves to turn their vision of their future into reality. Help your students to plan goals and when doing so, clearly set the stage for what success looks like and how will it feel to accomplish the goal. What will the reward they might get for the goal and what does it mean to be successful and why does it matter? Answering all of these questions can get your student excited about working towards the goal. And let students understand that they can have good mental health through physical fitness also. That is what another thing we can share with our students. And we have to be an example for our students. Show a positive, encouraging attitude in all that you say, do, and believe. Appreciate your students' efforts. And finally, your belief in your student can help them to find their sense of confidence and self-acceptance. And I would like to complete my presentation with the famous Gautam Buddha's quote, "Hard it is to train the mind, it goes where it likes and does what it wants. An unruly mind suffers and causes suffering whatever it does. But a well-trained mind brings health and happiness." We teachers shall train our students' brains to stay positive during this pandemic period. And this is what I would like to share with you all today. And I would like to thank you all for your time and attention. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. It was both very useful. Now, I invite our HOD, Dr. A. Narmada ma'am, to give report on 7 days workshop.
Thank you, ma'am. Before we get started, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to all of you who generously helped us make this event a grand success. We could not have done without your cooperation. We hope this workshop provided you all with the opportunity to refresh your knowledge of teaching and research. I shall give you a brief note on the proceedings of the event. On the first day, Dr. E. Sambasivan, Associate Professor, Department of Commerce, SA College of Arts and Science, Chennai, was the resource person. He explained what is an ideal research paper and how to pursue a research to have a desired result. On the second day, Dr. S. Subbulakshmi, Associate Professor and HOD, PG Department of Commerce, SNDNB, Vaishnava College, Chennai, was the resource person. She explained in clear terms of publication of research paper, particularly identifying the reputed journals like H-Index and I-10 Index journals. On the third day, Dr. A. Narmada, Associate Professor and HOD, Department of Management Studies, DB Jain College, Chennai, was the resource person. She spoke about the various agencies that give funds for research program. She also explained in detail the purpose of the fund and other criteria for obtaining it. Dr. Vidya, Associate Professor, Department of Management, PKR Arts and Science College, Women, Gobijati Palayam, was the resource person on the fourth day. She explained clearly how to prepare the best research project proposal and the nuances in doing so. Particularly, the components of the project report and proposed project abstract and preparation of the budget, etc. The session could be extremely helpful to the researcher. The session went on interestingly and was interactive. Dr. S. Ganapathy, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Corporate Secretaryship, SA College of Arts and Science, Chennai, was the resource person on the fifth day. He spoke on emerging new educational policies and his speech clearly and many doubts about the policy. Anuradha, Associate Professor and HOD, BBA Department, DRBCC Hindu College, Chennai, was the resource person on the sixth day and she spoke on emerging teaching practices. She explained how the 21st century teachers should conduct classes interestingly and taking the students along with them using interactive method and other latest technologies. On the final day, Professor M. Bharathi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Dhanraj Baid Jain College, Chennai, was the resource person. She spoke on teachers' role in boosting the students' mental health. She spoke factors affecting the mental health of the students of this century. She also explained the various way in which their mental health can be boosted. Finally, I would like to say one thing, the teachers are not born, but they are all made. We are all the responsible person. We need to continuously update our skills and knowledge for creating good citizen of our nation. Thank you, ma'am.
Now I invite Professor G. Anbalagan sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Management Studies, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning to all. It's my honor and privilege to be called upon to propose vote of thanks on this occasion. On behalf of Department of Management Studies, D.B. Jain College, Chennai, I would like to extend my gratitude in our management, trust member, Professor in Charge, Dr. M. Shaktivel Murugan, Principal Dr. C. Murugesan, Head of the Department, Dr. M. Narumala, and other faculty members for continued support and guidance in organizing this function. Next, to my heartfelt thanks, M. Bharathi, Associate Professor, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, B.B. Jain College, Chennai, for accepting in our invite and grace with us on this occasion. Thank you, madam. Your motivational and inspirational speech. Once again, thank you, one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.